Hey, welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe. And
hey, here we are.
50th anniversary of the show.
50th anniversary. That doesn't sound goodly.
I know. We've got to give a lot of credit to the crew, and they've got some things to show you about the crew in it.
Yeah.
Really, we couldn't do this without all the people. It actually takes dozens of people to do this show. A lot of work and effort. Courtney especially. Courtney's in there all the time. Jeff, Chris, all the people up in the booth with
Greg.
Greg.
Behind the curtain.
Can't forget Greg.
Greg.
But
Jack on our audio.
Yep. And, you know, usually there's Johnny up there. Wes is up there sometimes. Rick's up there. Sherry's doing stuff with the art. Just everybody gets involved in this.
All these people work on it, and still, we don't look any better than we do.
Well, we don't look as good as the girls, is what you're saying.
Well, we can't forget Kay, who actually does our makeup artist. Hey,
yeah, I mean,
that's right.
So many people involved.
So many people, and we really appreciate all of you out there watching. A lot of you online, obviously.
Definitely.
And a few of you now on Channel 97.
97.
And, but we'll move on, and we're going to be talking New Year's resolutions, things to do to really prepare yourself for a better computing experience at home during the 2009 year that's coming up.
So many people complain about this. I'm right at the top of the group. You know, after a few years, your computer, or a few months, computer just seems to slow down. And
right.
It's like, what can I do to keep my computer running at optimal speed?
Right.
And that's an important one. We're going to be talking a lot about things that you can do to make your computing experience better year-round.
And there's really, it has to do with the way that computers work. Every time you turn it on, turn it off, access programs, save stuff. All sorts of interactions have to happen in between the keyboard, what you're doing, and the inside of your computer. So, you know, over time, things get misaligned and out of shape, but there's ways to fix that. We're going to talk about that and a bunch of other good stuff today.
Okay.
So, here we go.
Now, let's get started with some of this. We made a simple list here, and these are mostly external things.
All right, so the number one thing you would do, Lee, is this what you're going to start with?
No, it's not the number one thing, because you and I fail at doing this so many times. Clean your monitor.
Clean your monitor.
This is your window. You want to be able to see things.
Right, and
we've got a mark on this one over here.
I know, and we work around it a little bit, but we were talking about this earlier, and there are a lot of products, things that you can get to spray on the screen with special cloths.
And you remember the old CRT, it had a glass cover on the front, and you could take the Windex and spray on it, no problem.
But nowadays with these LCD monitors,
you don't want to do that.
Where you've got really the display is not that well protected, you really have to be careful about the kind of cleaning product that you use.
So what do you recommend?
So we recommend this very, it's hard to find. It's difficult to get your hands on, but it's worth the extra effort of walking over to your sink.
They actually sell it in bottles.
They do, and getting some water.
Yes.
Now, if you want to be really obsessive about it, you can get water that's been filtered, you know. Mm-hmm. What's the kind that has everything removed from it? I forget the name of the kind of that.
I know what you mean, yeah.
But water. And,
Purified water
is the liquid that you should be using. Yeah, right, distilled water. Water is a liquid you should be, but the important thing is the kind of cloth that you use.
Right.
First of all, never, ever, ever use a paper product. No tissues, no paper towels, no napkins.
I'm thinking of what you usually
use. No newspapers.
See, there's a napkin. You know?
No 8.5 by 11. It doesn't matter how soft the paper feels to you. It has still got abrasive qualities to it that will, over time, damage your monitor. So you don't want to use that. You want to use a very soft cloth.
And microfiber is so popular today, really good thing to use. Microfiber cloth, just put a little water on
that. Right. So number one list, if we had 43 things up here and we're making a list.
It's a good idea.
We would make a list. We would put on our list, go to an office supply company and get a computer monitor cleaning cloth, less than $2. And then you just use that with, actually get two, is what I like to do.
Another nice lens cleaning would do, too.
Yeah, I have one lens cleaning solution. And you could buy the products. There'll be just a little bit of alcohol in there, but mostly it's just water. So I like to actually use two cloths. I take one, and I just make it real damp, wring it out real good. You don't want to have any water getting down behind the protective glass. And then I apply that. I let it rest on there for a few seconds. I do it when the monitor's off so it's not warm, and I can see it better. And then after the water has had a chance to dissolve whatever, you know, is on it, all the schmutz, then come back with a clean cloth, same kind of cloth, wipe it down. takes a few minutes, and really, it makes a huge difference on what you're doing.
On our Black Friday show, we actually talked about another thing that we found. It was a geek gift.
Right.
But it's really cool. One of the hardest things to clean is this thing right here.
Yeah, and luckily...
And it gets dirty. Stuff falls down in here. You don't know what's living in there.
Luckily, Apple went away from their clear plastic keyboard. I still have one of those at home, and that's a real pain because stuff actually falls down in little crumbs, cookie crumbs.
But if you go back to that old show, we found a thing. It was like a... Play-Doh thing. You just squeeze it down into keys, and it adheres to everything.
Well, here's the first thing I would do with my keyboard, Lee, is just like this.
I do that all the time,
take it up, turn it over, knock it out, knock the dust loose.
Don't do it on your desk.
Blow it off.
Make a mess of your desk.
Yeah, oh, well, sorry. So, I mean, that's the first thing you can do. And then you got always a little bit of schmutz from your hands, you know, newsprint.
Wipe it off, but you got to be careful. I mean, you don't want to get that thing wet and short it out.
Right, same kind of thing. Water works really well. I mean, you know, it just works really well. Soft cloth. Very damp, wring it out real good, wipe it off, let it rest, come back with a dry one.
Now, we were talking about cleaning the inside of your computer, too, and this is more PC-specific.
Right.
And
well, any computer that is a tower. Now, on the Macintosh here, and now on some PCs like HP and some others have some all-in-one kind of models like this, you can't really open these up. I mean, you can, but you got to be...
Don't do it.
Yeah, you can, but you shouldn't.
Don't.
But on a tower computer, which is real typical for PCs, Windows-based computers are typically like that. Mac has them as well.
Yeah.
But there is a case, and inside the case is a fan. And the job of the fan is to pull air from the outside into the computer.
There's dirt in that air.
There's dirt in the air.
Yeah, you're breathing it right now.
So when I'm pulling air into my computer over a course of several years... I'm pulling in dirty air, and what's happening to the dust inside this closed box?
It's all accumulating in there. In fact, we've got some pictures here of some really amazing
dirty pictures here, Lee. I'm not sure we can do that.
We found dirty computers, and I'm going to pull this up here for you. And we'll look at the full-size picture of this. Let's see, we'll open that. And that is, I mean, this might be extreme, but you'd be amazed at how much garbage actually gets pulled into your computer.
That's pretty extreme.
I
asked somebody who's working in an asbestos factory. Actually, I used to have my first computer. I had a cabinet shop. And I used to do a lot of, we did custom woodwork, and there's always wood dust in the air, and my computer would almost get that dirty. So what's the problem with having a dirty computer, Lee? So what's the big deal?
It's going to affect performance. It's going to affect the cooling. Your CPU can overheat. And actually, not just cleaning it, but there's a few things that you can do to prevent it from getting so dirty.
Right.
And the best thing to do is don't put your computer on the floor. Down on the floor is where there's a lot of dust that settles down there. It'll be dirtier there. If you can keep it up on a table, up on your desk, anywhere like that,
or even a little stand. Even if you put it up on a little, if you have it on the floor, put it up on a little stand so you get it above the floor. Depending on where the fan is, if your fan's right down at the floor level, you know, everything settles to the floor, and now you're pulling...
And if you have pets,
stuff's
coming
pets,
in there, too.
Right.
It gets really, really dirty.
Right. So the other thing dust can do, it actually it can interfere with the electrical contacts inside on your motherboard, so you can get some really weird behaviors. You know, if you're wondering, my computer is just, you know, suddenly it goes blank, or there's strange things happening. Surprisingly enough, sometimes it could just be dust on the inside. So now, how do we take care of this, Lee?
Well, some of them you got to take the case off. They're real easy releases now. They've improved that. But there's some of them have a filter in it. So
And so once you get the case off, though, don't get the vacuum cleaner out. What you want is a can of compressed air. So put that on your list when you go down to the office supply. Soft cloth and a can of compressed
air. Bottled water.
Blow out the dust. Blow it out. Okay. And when we come back from the break, we're going to talk a little bit more about computer maintenance, and we'll be back in just a minute.
Okay.